Hello everyone. These two NVMe drives are almost identical. They both have a capacity of 2 terabytes, they both have the TLC memory technology, and they both have 2 gigabytes of DRAM cache. Now, what's different about them is that the TimeTech is a PCIe Gen 3 and the Crucial P5 Plus is a PCIe Gen 4. And theoretically, the PCIe Gen 4 drive is faster than the PCIe Gen 3 drive. But how much this performance difference will affect the day-to-day use of your PC? So in my video, I'll be performing a series of tests to be able to determine this. I'll be launching some games. I'll be copying also some files, large files, medium and small files, to see how these NVMe drives will cope with the day-to-day use of a PC. And of course, I'll be also performing a Windows boot test. And at the end, I'll be launching a Crystal Disk Mark on both drives for two reasons. The first reason is to verify the speed claim of the manufacturer of these drives. And the second reason is to see how much this drive will heat up when you stress them. Before starting the tests, I wanted to show you quickly how the drives are installed in my PC. So I have a PC with a motherboard of Asus Prime B550 Plus, and this motherboard has 2 M.2 slots. The first one is PCIe Gen 3, where I installed the TimeTech drive, and the second one is PCIe Gen 4, where I installed the Crucial P5 Plus drive. In this first test, I'm testing how much time will it take for Windows to boot from each drive. And here the drives are exactly configured the same, and my PC doesn't have any other hard drive connected to it when I perform this test. And you see that the Gen 4 drive started in 20 seconds, whereas the Gen 3 drive started in 21 seconds, and this is really a negligible difference. The first game I'm launching is Fortnite, and this is a really very heavy game, so it is 35 gigabytes. And by the way, here both drives are configured exactly the same. And here the Crucial Gen 4 drive launched the game 1 second faster than the TimeTech Gen 3 drive. So it launched it in 40 seconds, whereas the Gen 3 drive launched it in 41 seconds. And this is really a negligible difference. Now I'm launching PUBG, and here also the Gen 4 Crucial P5 Plus NVMe drive was faster than the TimeTech MS-12 Gen 3 NVMe drive by only 1 second. So the Gen 4 drive launched the game in 48 seconds, whereas the Gen 3 drive launched the game in 49 seconds. Now I'm testing the third game, which is Assetto Corsa Competition. And here also the same story, both drives performed exactly the same. So both drives launched the game in 30 seconds. And we see that in game launching, there are no advantages from the Gen 4 drive over the Gen 3 drive. But will this be the case in the file copy testing? Let's see by starting the file copy test now. In this first file copy test, I'm copying a large file that is 35 gigabytes from the same drive to the same drive so that for the test to be accurate. And here the Gen 4 drive crushed the Gen 3 drive. It was averaging 1905 megabytes per second, whereas the Gen 3 drive was averaging only 700 megabytes per second. And this is a huge advantage for the Gen 4 drive. In this test, I'm copying a mixture of photos and videos, and this is a more representative test of day-to-day use of your PC. And here, the Gen 4 drive also outperformed the Gen 3 drive. It performed the operation in 13 seconds, and it was averaging 932 megabytes per second, whereas the Gen 3 drive finished the operation in 18 seconds and it was averaging 680 megabytes per second. In this test that is particularly hard on any hard drive, I'm copying 42,566 small files that are 12.3 gigabytes from the same drive to the same drive. And here also the Gen 4 drive outperformed the Gen 3 drive. It was averaging 112 megabytes per second, and it finished the operation in 1 minute 49 seconds, whereas the Gen 3 drive was averaging 96 megabytes per second, and it finished the operation in 2 minutes and 8 seconds. For the Crystal Disk Mark benchmark test, I increased the number of times from 5 to 9 so that to stress the drives and to see the temperature that they will reach. The highest temperature that the Crucial drive reached was 72 degrees, whereas the highest temperature that the TimeTech reached was 62 degrees. Now for the results of the Crystal Mark benchmark test, the Crucial drive achieved the advertised reach speed, which is 6600 megabytes per second, And in the right speed, it didn't achieve the advertised speed, so it reached only 4,128 megabytes per second instead of 5,000 megabytes per second. Now, for the TimeTech drive, it didn't achieve the advertised speed neither in the read or on the write operation. So in the read operation, it was almost 1 gigabytes below the advertised speed, and in the write operation, it was about 700 megabytes below the average advertised speed. Now, the most interesting numbers in this test are the numbers of the random read and write. And you notice that the Gen 3 TimeTech outperformed the Gen 4 Crucial P5 Plus drive in two of the random 4K read and write speeds, and it was almost the same in the other random 4K read and write speeds. So as you saw in the tests, the Gen 4 drive performed a little bit better than the Gen 3 drive in almost all the tests, apart from the file copying tests, where the Gen 4 drive performed really better than the Gen 3 drive. Now, what drive should you choose? If you copy files like most of the time, of course, the Gen 4 drive is better than the Gen 3 drive. But if you're just using the PC for gaming or even for video editing or other stuff, you saw that the Gen 3 drive was really very close to the Gen 4 drive. And if the price of the Gen 3 drive is really lower than the Gen 4 drive, I say go with the Gen 3 drive. But if the prices are similar or the Gen 4 drive is just a little bit more expensive than the Gen 3 drive, of course, go with the Gen 4 drive. It is future-proof and it is faster in all the tests that you saw. By the way, if you wanna check out any of these drives, I'm gonna leave an affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I wanna thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.